There is anger in India after a 27-year-old veterinarian was allegedly gang-raped and murdered by four men. Over the weekend, this crowd gathered outside the police station where the accused men were being held and demanded police hand them over to face justice. The four men allegedly burnt her body and dumped it beneath a flyover in Hyderabad City in South India. Police say the men earlier offered to help the doctor repair her scooter and then gang-raped her by dragging her to a secluded place. Outrage over the brutal rape and murder is spilling onto social media with calls for justice, even vigilante justice. The hashtag #HangRapists was trending on Twitter over the weekend. Now, here's a user from Hyderabad who said, "We build the tallest statues, claim to have the world's largest democracy. Too unfortunate that we fail to make our country safe for women and girls." And then this from a fan account of Bollywood star Disha Patani, who says, "There's no better way to depict women in India than this." And DW correspondent Nimisha Jaiswal joins me now from Delhi with more. Nimisha, this case seems to have hit a nerve across the country. Why is that?
Well, Paresh, one of the reasons could be that the gruesome and shocking details that are emerging about this case are sparking this outrage, and protests have broken out across the country. Just the pre-planned nature of this assault, these men who gang-raped the veterinarian had actually seen her hours before the assault and had planned out how to assault her, how to take her aside. They had even damaged her vehicle so that they could take advantage of her isolation. And just the details that have emerged, the fact that she was raped and then she was suffocated and killed and then burnt under a bridge. It's just been completely morbid and shocking, and the more details that have emerged, the more disturbed people have been. And the fact that law enforcement has also been slack has also caused more outrage. People are baying for blood. People are calling for these people to be not only hung, and some are even calling for them to be lynched and attacked by the people themselves.
What are the next steps in this? What are law enforcement authorities saying?
Well, Paresh, now that the case has captured national attention, there is a lot of response coming from authorities, both when it comes to enforcement authorities as well as politicians. The chief minister of the state where this assault happened has called for a fast-track court, which basically means that these people would be brought to justice sooner, according to the leader. And also, the police have churned out reports fairly quickly. All the men who have been accused have been picked up already. But there is also criticism. Three police officers were suspended because they were seen as slacking off when the family first went to file the report. And because of this, further action could be taken against them as well. So there is also outrage directed at politicians. Neighbors surrounding the family to which the victim belonged have actually pushed out not only the media, but also politicians, because they say they don't want sympathy, they want answers.
Nimisha, India was shocked in 2012 after the brutal gang rape of a girl in a moving bus in Delhi. Laws were changed, penalties were made harsher. Has anything really changed since then?
Well, Paresh, the thing to note about the gang rape you speak of 7 years ago is that it did spark a national conversation about assault against women, about violence against women. And more women have spoken out about the violence they have faced as well as the constant harassment they have faced in this country. The Me Too movement, for example, also touched a nerve in India. And because of this, the conversation around rape as well as the laws around rape have become stronger, have become more prevalent. But, however, there's also a lot of incidences that continue to happen. Even just over the last few days, there have been rapes reported from people ranging from 6 years old to 55 years old. So perhaps it's not just about laws and enforcement. There's a societal behavioral change that is needed, that needs to be thought about and implemented across the country.
And that's where we will leave it. Nimisha Jaiswal in Delhi, thank you so much for that.